It's been a year since the Gold Coast City Council started its successful koala relocation program. But the Koala Foundation wants to go a step further, with protection no matter where the koalas live.
This patch of bushland in Coomera on the Gold Coast is home to a koala population in peril. Their home is slowly disappearing to make room for ours. This bushland is in the way of a sprawling residential development. Now the koalas have to be relocated. They've simply run out of room.
Won't be able to sustain the number of koalas that are here now.
John Callaghan and his team have been tracking down and capturing the koalas. The animals have then moved onto council-owned property in the hinterland. So far, the project's working.
There are a lot of complexities to the project, but overall we're seeing a high level of success with the program.
But the fact the program was even needed is proof to some that koalas are not being managed properly.
Because we've got so much infrastructure occurring at the moment, so many housing estates, I honestly don't think any government, especially here in Queensland, wants to have the koala in the way.
Federal Environment Minister Tony Burke was last week handed a report proposing koalas be relisted nationally as a vulnerable species. Certain groups in Queensland want the federal government to take an even tougher stance. They want koalas declared critically endangered, which would mean developments encroaching on their habitats could be blocked. The minister says he'll consider the idea, but won't make a decision for 3 months.
This actually gives the opportunity for the federal government to say, is this really a good thing? A bit like the Traveston Dam.
On the Gold Coast, Simon Hooper, 10 News.